Right, welcome to a somewhat special episode of the sketch show of No Name. It's just me and Jesse, I think, in this one. Isn't it, Jesse?
Yeah, it's just us two. And couldn't be gladder to bring this to you. You want to go ahead and tell them what's going on, Jack?
Yeah, sure. So, a few months ago, is it a few months or a few years now? A long, long time ago in a university far, far away, we, of course, started off with our sketch show working for a student radio station called OMG. We're allowed to say the name now because we're not in the university. We left that, but later on they came back to us looking for free labour, so we did a special episode, just me and Jesse, called The New News As It's New, where we commented on new news, which is no longer new because it's old news. And it was just never aired. Something tells me it's probably the joke about child slavery, but you can make your own mind up. Hello, welcome to the new news as it's new. Today, we'll be reading the news. Coming up, the Mars Perseverance rover has successfully landed. The Amazon CEO, Jeff Bezos, has stepped down from his role. And the poor people make money, which the rich people don't like. But first, music.
Thank you. then I pray for the light. And sometimes the light's no consolation.
And now the news. Recently, Amazon CEO Jeff Bezos has announced he's stepping down from his role. When asked to comment, he simply hissed at us and slithered into a nearby sewer. Glenn McCaskill reports.
Hello, I'm Glenn McCaskill, attempting to get some Vox Pops from Amazon employees.
Well, what do you mean by tempting?
Well, when I ask them a question, they stay focused on their work. I tried to talk to five people. One of them told me he couldn't talk or he'd get fired. Shortly after saying that, an alarm went off and some man dressed in a metallic suit used a flamethrower on him. It was pretty cool, if not quite horrific.
Oh my god. But then what happened?
Then I walked away. He had a flamethrower. What do you think I'm gonna do? Try and fight him?
Okay, fair enough. Where are you now?
I'm trying to get a six vox pop. I'm currently outside the employee bathroom waiting to interview someone on their way in, but no one has come to it yet.
How long have you been there?
A few hours. They appear to be urinating in bottles, so it's taking a while.
It what?
I guess they just have that kind of work ethic. It must be great to work here if you really don't want to leave what you're doing that much. Wait, hang on. I think I actually see someone who's coming and taking a break. I'll go and interview them. Give me a moment.
Okay, Glenn. You had me worried you weren't going to get a story for a moment, mate.
Me too. Excuse me, sir. Sir, excuse me. Sir? He's not taking a break. He's just dead.
He's dead?
Aye. Shame. Or at least I think he is. Let me just... Aye. Yep. Yep. He's definitely dead. Back to you in the studio.
Okay, then. When we asked our local MP for their comments on the story, they expressed concern that Jeff Bezos wouldn't be able to function in society now that his source of income is gone. Luckily, they added that if he applies for a PIP assessment, he'll get at least 1 point for his distinct lack of soul.
Gotta take a break, I'm telling you, so maybe take a break. I know you work so hard, and I know it's really hard.
It's hard sometimes.
Gotta take a break.
Listen to me.
You deserve a break.
Yeah.
Maybe drink some water. Cause you really need the water.
Yeah.
Or else you'll die soon. Yeah, you will die soon. Please drink some water. Please drink some water. Or else you'll die soon. You don't wanna die soon. But you want that water. So please drink some water.
Take a break. time.
And now, sports. Our printer's on Fritz, so I'm afraid we only have 2020 sports stats ready right now. Anyway, here's the sports. And that was the sports.
Your sports team is vastly inferior. That simple fact is plainly obvious to see. We're gonna kick your collective posterior. Of course you realize we're speaking figuratively. Our stats are thoroughly impressive. Our coach really has the Midas touch. Our players are fast and strong and brave and your guys, yeah. Not so much. In fact, we've played teams across the nation, and you're the worst one we've come across. Try to assimilate that information, and it just might help you cope with your impending loss. Oh, and if somehow we are still failing to effectively articulate the points at hand, allow us now to summarize them in a manner that your feeble brains can understand. We're great,
we're great.
And you suck.
You suck.
We're great,
we're great.
And you suck.
You suck.
We're great,
we're great.
And you suck.
You suck.
You see, there's us,
we're great.
And then there's you.
You suck.
We're really, really great.
We're great.
In contrast, you really suck.
Really suck.
Okay, full disclosure, we're not that great, but nevertheless, you suck. Team will soon suffer swift defeat. That theory's backed up by empirical evidence. We're gonna grind up your guys into burger meat. Again, of course, we're speaking in the figurative sense. What's the use of even going through the motions when you know that you're gonna lose anyhow? So why don't you save us all some time and give up now?
You suck.
Hello. Hi. Do you want to go to a party with me? No. The game's on. Oh, I almost forgot. I'll be right there.
We like sports and we don't care who knows. From shooting hoops to the Super Bowl. We like sports and we don't care who knows.
Football. Football.
Football.
Tennis.
Hockey.
Golf.
The game is starting. Everyone is here. I got my snacks, my friends, and a beer.
Just two normal guys hanging out, having fun. Right, guy number two?
Yeah, guy number one.
E
to the S
to the P
to the N is all I watch, cause I'm the man.
If my team loses, I'll be mean all night. If you tell me to relax, we'll get in a fight.
Watching sports with girls is a pain. They don't know the rules, there's no time to explain.
Single,
double,
triple,
home run.
For the celebration, I'll shoot my gun.
I like my friend, he's a real guy's guy. He's not a loudmouth like that c**hole Steve.
We like sports and we don't care who knows. From Wimbledon
to the Astrodome.
We like sports and we don't care who knows.
Football,
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 tennis,
hockey,
golf.
Now when I say sports, you say nuts. Sports,
nuts,
sports,
nuts. When I say cheating, you say sucks. Cheating,
sucks,
cheating,
sucks. I drink whiskey cause I like the taste. You think it's bitter, but I think it's great.
I also drink whiskey and we smoke cigars. Don't believe me? Smell our cars.
We're real men and we like sports. If you say that we're not, then we'll see you in court.
I'm team captain and I choose you.
I'm the other team captain and I choose you too.
We steal the ball and we're off to the races.
Then scare the other team with our mad dog faces like
what? What?
We like sports and we don't care who knows.
From the pregame jokes
to the wrap-up show.
We like sports and we don't care who knows.
Football,
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 tennis,
hockey,
golf.
Throw me the baseball.
Now toss me the pigskin.
Now feed me the rock.
Now give me the rock.
News from a stock market recently as GameStop stocks have plummeted. caused by a change in policy from a popular brokering app, Robinhood, people were locked out of buying GME, causing the prices to fall severely. At this point, only foolish and daring can hope the stocks will go back above its peak of over $400, Glenn McCaskill reports.
GameStop is doing better than ever.
Of course.
We've had some slight problems along the way, like losing my wife, family, and house, but hopes are still high that GameStop will rise again.
What about all the roadblocks the Wall Street elite have put in the way to stop it from rising
again? Well, the Wall Street elite are rich, but that's why I'm using Robinhood. They take from the rich and give to the poor. In this case, me, and I have lost so much money.
But Robinhood was forced by big investment firms to change their policies regarding GME. In fact, investors admitted that it would have went up to thousands if not for these policies. Robinhood stepped aside when their profits were threatened.
They can still get up to the thousands. All we need to do is hold on GME and live in our cars. Mine's a red Vauxhall Astra, red like a brick house. They're pretty much the same.
So you're confident that'll go back up?
I am.
Thank you, Glenn.
Goodbye.
As I was reporting, only foolish and daring can hope the stocks will go back to the previous highs. We have asked several Wall Street investors if they would care to comment, to which they replied with ew and hit us with a cane.
I'm Glenn McCaskill and I'm being hit with a cane, help!
Greenbacks tumble, feel the starlet crumble.
other news, there's tensions on the streets of London as third day protests go on. When asked about protests, a local MP replied with protest. What protest? I didn't notice a protest. Hey Sam, do you notice a protest? No? No, Sam didn't notice a protest either. Glenn McCaskill reports. Again.
Hello, I'm Glenn McCaskill. I'm in London at a protest.
What's the protest about? What's the name?
There's a big sign that says protest.
So you don't know what it's about?
I don't. Let me try ask someone.
Okay.
Excuse me, sir. You're not dead, are you?
What? Why would I be dead?
I think it happens more often than you'd think. Can you tell me what this is?
It's a protest.
And what are you protesting?
You know, things, injustices and the like.
Is there any specific injustice you're protesting?
Yeah.
Which one?
Hang on one second.
Okay.
Hey, what are we protesting again? We are? Oh, okay. I've got you.
It appears that the protesters are discussing...
children.
You're protesting children.
Wait, no. Hang on. Child labour, my bad.
Are you for child labour or against?
What sort of question is that? Glenn, give me the earpiece so I can speak to
you. Are you sure? It's a very demanding job.
Do it, Glenn. So, what are you actually suggesting we do about this?
Oh, you know, things.
Things?
Yeah, like, we do some things. Maybe work on stuff, donate.
Have you actually got any sort of plan?
Yeah, we're protesting.
In front of Parliament?
No. We couldn't get the clearance to do it in front of Parliament. So we're in front of the Nodian. Couldn't even afford to get clearance for Cineworld.
And what would you have done if you did it in front of Parliament?
Protested.
And how would you suggest fixing the worldwide problem of child labour?
Well, okay. We'd just tell them to stop, and they would try.
Give the earpiece back to Glenn. The Scottish one.
Hello.
I wanted to congratulate you, Glenn.
Thanks.
For somehow finding someone with less brains than you.
Oh.
Bye, Glenn.
Hungry and the rich keep getting fat. Politicians change, but they're never gonna change that. But you and me, girl, we got the answer right in our hands. All we gotta do is tide is coming in. Don't you be hoping for the good times, because the good times have already been. But girl, we got the answer, so easy you won't believe. All we gotta do is it's so easy to see. If only they'd listen to you and me. We got to till we can. We got to woman every man. We got to time after time.
we got to occur in line.
Envoyez à l'amour. J'ai su tes ordres, mais un con reste un con. Vous avez vos papiers? Entassez-vous dans les immeubles et monte! Parlez-en, vous construisez nos foyers? Je suis pas raciste, mais il n'y a pas place pour tout le monde!
And now, more news. The Mars Perseverance rover has successfully touched ground on Mars. We would show you pictures, but this is for radio, so I'll describe it. There's some rocks, sand or something like that. More rock. Basically, it's like a quarry. It looks exactly like a quarry. Like the BBC has ran out of Doc 2 budget again. Just rocks. Rocks as far as the eye can see. Glenn McCaskill reports.
Hello, I'm Glenn McCaskill. Again, I'm here at Mars investigating the real story behind this.
You're where?
Mars.
The planet?
No, it'd be pretty difficult to get to that planet now, wouldn't it? I'm at the chocolate company place.
What? Why?
Well, to find out why they'd need to send a rover here in the first place. What's the point of it? Something must be afoot. And I, as a journalist with integrity, must find out what.
Why would they send a rover there?
Like I said, that's what I'm trying to find out. Probably because of the slaves.
What?
Child slaves. They work at the cocoa plantations in Mali, near the Ivory Coast.
Is that true?
Aye. 8 former child slaves are currently suing Mars Incorporated, as well as Nestle, Cargill, Barry Cabot, Olam International, the Hershey Company, and Mondelez. But as this is an Ofcom regulated broadcast, I must mention that other human rights abusers are available. I should also mention they're former child slaves because they're no longer slaves, not because they just grew up.
So that was an actual report then? A semi-factual report?
That's right. Only the most cutting-edge journalism from me.
Well, I guess that's time to go to a song.
Ground control to Major Tom. Ground control to Major Tom. Take your protein pills and put your helmet on. Ground control to Major Tom. Commencing countdown, engines on. 3, 2, check ignition, 1. And may God's love lift be off. With you. This is ground control to Major Tom.
Thank you. It's a god-awful small affair to the girl with the mousy hair. But her mummy is yelling no, and her daddy has told her to go. But her friend is nowhere to be seen. Now she walks through her sunken dream to the seat with the clearest view, and she's hooked to the silver screen. But the film is a saddening bore, for she's lived it 10 times or more. She could spit in the eyes of fools as they ask her to focus on sailors fighting in the dance hall. Is there life on Mars? It's on America's tortured brow. Mickey Mouse has grown up a cow. Now the workers have struck for fame, 'cause Lennon's on sale again. See the mice in their million hordes, from Ibiza to the Norfolk Broads. Rule Britannia is out of bounds to my mother, my dog and clown. But the film is a saddening bore, 'cause I wrote it 10 times or more. It's about to be writ again as I ask you to focus on sailors fighting in the dance hall. Oh man, look at those cavemen go. It's a cut the
And now for our weekly film review. Groundhog Day was it? Groundhog Day? Okay. Groundhog Day. Starring a star-studded cast such as Tom Cruise and some other people. This movie's about a man who is stuck in a time loop he can't get out of. Over the course of the movie, Tom Cruise keeps dying in his weird alien-style mech suit. And has to do something or other about some aliens that control time or something. The plot's somehow both forgettable and not at the same time. It's okay.
They say we're young and we don't know. Won't find out.
And now for our weekly film review. Groundhog Day was it? Groundhog Day? Okay. Groundhog Day. Starring a star-studded cast such as Tom Cruise and some other people. This movie's about a man who is stuck in a time loop he can't get out of. Over the course of the movie, Tom Cruise keeps dying in his weird alien-style mech suit and has to do something or other about some aliens that control time or something. The plot's somehow both forgettable and not at the same time. It's okay.
They say we're young and we don't know. Won't find out till we grow.
Well, I don't know. Well, that's true. 'Cause you got me, baby, I got you. Hey. I got you, babe. I got you, babe. They say I love.
Now for our weekly film review. Groundhog Day was it? Groundhog Day? Okay. Groundhog Day. Starring a star-studded cast such as Tom Cruise and some other people. This movie's about a man who is stuck in a time loop he can't get out of. Of course,
we'll do
the movie.
A quick commentary for the end, shall we? What do you think of the new news as it's new, Jesse?
Oh, the nerds as it's nerds, as it's new, should I say? Yeah, it was... I didn't think the episode was that bad. Maybe that's just me, but our comedy, we knew our limits. We knew what the lines were. I just feel like it just might have pushed on other people's lines, and that's maybe why it didn't get aired.
Yeah.
But I didn't think it was too... on the nose, you know. I do think we dealt with the, you know, the things in a way that you know, still was humorous, and I don't think we crossed any lines.
The there was a lot of social commentary in it, and I know you meant to stay neutral, but we specifically went for social commentary that we thought no one could disagree with. Like, hey, slavery, especially child slavery, is bad. And I know we're meant to be impartial, but I don't think anyone's going, well, actually, I'll have you know that it just means we get cheap labour, which makes costs go down. Like, no one's going to argue with child slavery is a bad thing.
If I'm honest with you, when it comes to that show, I don't actually remember anything to do with that sketch. I don't even remember, because when they say the one with the child slavery and or, you know, back then, or when you and Joel were talking about it, I didn't know what you were both talking about, if I'm honest with you, and I still don't know which one it is that you were talking about.
Well, when this was made, it was recent. It's not recent now. There was,
I guess, in a weird way, this is the new news as it's now.
Old news as it's old.
Old news as it's old, but being told as if it's new news.
Exactly. But it's there was a story about chocolate companies and some former child slaves suing the chocolate companies. And the joke about that was it was the only thing Glenn McCaskill, the returning incompetent news anchor, actually did seriously. Because it's a serious subject. So the joke there is that there is no real joke. And it was just something that we
I really
felt...
should remember this, shouldn't I?
Yeah, you were the... Yeah.
I remember so many of my sketches as Glenn McCaskill, and I just can't recall it.
Because this one was never published due to the powers that be. Impartiality. It's like, it's just, you don't go on to BBC News whenever there's like a story about like a murderer, but don't go, and now for impartiality, we need to bring on our resident murderer. Say hello to Steve Kills People Guy. Which is a strange last name, I must admit.
I've heard more unoriginal names.
Like Glenn McCaskill.
Or Steve Stevington.
Yeah. It's, we never came up with a name for...
Was there anything else about the episode, or was that really the big no-no?
That's a good question. I think that was the main thing, but there were parts where we pushed boundaries, but in a way that, like, no one could possibly disagree with us.
Do we have plans to release it?
I mean, that's why we're recording it. They've just listened to it. If they're listening to this, they just listen to... This is
right, we'll cut that question out.
No, then. I'm not cutting it.
I had to clarify.
I'm not cutting that. That's too... Hey.
Just my cluelessness of what's going on right now.
Basically, what happened is we were reminiscing on the sketch show. We were just... And I mentioned that I don't think OMG ever released new news as it's new. And we had a look to see if we still had it. And I did. And I said, you know what? I'm going to record a quick... introduction. Do you want to get on this and start up your recording software, and we can do it how we used to do it? Because we used to do the sketch show No Name.
That, like this. This is how we used to do it. Yeah.
We used to do it remotely, and that was before COVID. We were the first to do it remotely. We spearheaded remote recording in that station. And
just you wait till the people listening hear about radio.
It's. We spearheaded that, and we were the ones who basically showed that it was possible. And once COVID happened, they were all like, right, here's how we're going to do it. And it was basically the same that we did, except for they got free microphones. We didn't. I had to. That's why the microphone quality is so low. Mine was like 15 quid. So.
But we made the best out of it. And you know, we were all happy. You know, me, yourself, Jack, and Joe, we were all happy with how it came out.
Yeah, it's. I think something that some people may be able to tell if they're still listening to this is we mainly did the show for ourselves. We were focused on making ourselves laugh rather than making other people laugh, which is probably not the formula to a successful sketch show, but it is a formula to a happy life. So, yeah, it was a fun
time. Thank you
time.
For coming to our TED Talk. No, but it's, you know, it's great to be able to finally release this episode and just get it out there. I'm so glad we have a copy of it.
Yeah.
And, you know, enjoy the episode.
They've just listened to it. This is at the end. Really.
Oh, hope you enjoyed the episode. You said intro earlier.
I was recording an intro, and then I said, and I'm going to leave that part
commentary bit for the end.
Yeah.
All right. Oh, no. Oh, now I'm even... Oh.
This regularly happened. We recorded an hour's worth of sketches, but it regularly took like 3 or 4 hours to record.
But you know what? Thanks for listening anyway.
Yes, thank you for listening. It's been a great pleasure.
Yeah.
If you're wondering what our upload schedule is, it's just whatever we feel like, whenever we feel like. You may get future audio sketches.
We're both doing a lot in our lives, so stay tuned to just see whatever is coming up. We're always busy doing something.
Yeah. It's one day you may get a noir film made using experimental technology. The next you may get a very bittersweet pseudo-documentary. And then later on you'll get jokes about child slavery. It's really a mixed bag with us. Thanks for listening.
Stay tuned to be announced for season 3 of The Sketch Show With No Name. Coming soon. Kind of, maybe.
Soon in graphics. Air quotes. It's coming whenever we do it. It's recorded. It's coming when it's edited.
We've done a bit of it, but we're not there yet. So just bear with us and we'll be, you know.
How long
stand
ago
by.
Now did we record it?
How long ago was it that we recorded it? It was Oh, I think it was...
It was when we came back for our final year, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was just before, I think.
The week before
we came in on the Wednesday, I think.
Yeah.
We came in and went to the recording studio on campus, and we recorded season 3, and it has been a long... It'll be coming up on a year and in a couple months since we recorded it.
Mm. We regularly Craziness. Listen back to it, don't we? In fact, we were listening back to it today. We were listening back to...
Yeah, just before recording this.
Yeah, we were just reminiscing, you know? Like I said, we really mainly did it for us. Yeah.
But yeah, thanks for listening. We appreciate it. We hope you stick around as much as sticking around can be for something that is unconfirmed.
Yeah.
But has been recorded and is.
Don't think of it as unconfirmed. Think of it as a mystery release date.
It is. It will be a surprise. So make sure you're subscribed to the YouTube channel. You're following the playlist on Spotify, Apple Music, wherever it is that you listen to these things. And of course, just. Stay tuned.
I think this one has music in it, so it'll be on YouTube, this one. Because we can't put it on, like, Anchor or anything for that. So, yes, most of them will be on Spotify.
But still, follow us on... yeah, still follow the playlists, because when we do get season 3 releasing, you'll be notified, or if you're following the stream, you'll be able to see the new releases as they come out.
Or Twitter. If you follow us on Twitter, you can also find it there.
Find out the new news as it's new.
I've realised I keep moving around the chair, so my levels are going to be incredibly all over the place.
We should probably wrap this up.
Yeah. It's 12 minutes. Yeah. Good times. Thanks. Good times. Well, if I don't see you later, good afternoon, good evening, good night.
All right, Truman, count it.